All right, this is fourth grade module one, lesson two. We're going to be continuing talking about place value, and we're going to continue that concept of recognizing that the columns are related by a factor of 10. For example, if you have 5,000s and you have 500s, we want students to recognize that 5,000s is 10 times bigger than 500s, and that 500s is 10 times bigger than 5 tens, and that 5 tens is 10 times bigger than 5 ones. So really, if we were going to multiply this by 10, it would give us 5 in the 10,000s column. Similarly, if we were to take this 5 and multiply by 10, it would give us 5 in the thousands column, etc. So let's put this into practice. So it says, as you did during the lesson, ostensibly this is going to happen, teachers, in the classroom, and parents, maybe, hopefully this happened in the classroom today. Label and represent the product or quotient by drawing discs on the place value chart. So the idea is, we know that there's this beautiful shortcut that parents and teachers often know. Oh, just add a zero, or oh, just chop off a zero. But the purpose of this lesson is to explain, try and demonstrate why that thing happens. And so that students, we're going to try and give students a chance to develop some number sense. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to fill in the labels, ones, tens, hundreds, thousands, and then, oh my goodness, 10,000s. And in this case, that's going to be enough. And it says, the first thing we're going to do, we're going to do 10 times 4,000s. So we're going to take that 4,000s, and we're going to model that in our place value chart. So it's going to look like 1, 2, 3, 4, all right? And then, because it says we're going to have 10 times that, we need to have 10 rows of this. So let's get going. So that's 1 row, 2 rows, 3 rows, 4 rows, 5 rows, 6 rows, 7, 8, 9, and 10. So we now have 10 rows. So what does that mean? That means we now have 40,000s. How do I know that? Well, because we have 10 by 4. So 10 times 4 is 40. So we now have 40,000s. But we know that for every 10, so we have 10 right here, means we can cash those in for a dot in the next column over. We can cash these 10 in for a dot over here. We can cash these 10 for a dot over here. And lastly, we can cash these 10 for a dot over here. And that gives us 4,000s. Oops, nope, 4 10,000s. That gives us 4 10,000s. Another way you can write 4 10,000s is to say we have 40,000. All right, because we have 4 10,000s, so that means we have 40,000s. Now here's the cool thing I want our students to start noticing here. And I want our students to start noticing that we had 4 in the thousands column. And then when we multiplied by 10, what happened? Well, when we multiplied by 10, that eventually meant we ended up with 4 in the 10,000s column. All right, so this kind of went away, and it's as if the 4 moved to the column to the left. It moved one space to the left. That's kind of the shortcut, teachers, that we eventually want our students to start seeing. Now, this is the exact reverse, so we're going to write ones, tens, hundreds, thousands, and then 10,000s. All right. And we're going to divide by 10 this time. So we're going to begin by modeling our fourth thousands. So one, two, three, four. So we have four thousands. But now we need to divide that by 10. So the way we're going to do that is we, for each one of these dots in the thousands column, we're going to cash it in for 10 in the hundreds column. So we can see that this guy right here is going to get cashed in for 10. 10 in the hundreds column. And then we can see that this guy is going to get cashed in for 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 in the tens column. And then each one of these guys in the thousands column is going to be cashed in for 10 in the hundreds column. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So now, what do we end up with? Well, we end up with 40. Whoa, I'm going to erase that. We're going to end up with 40 hundreds right here. 40 hundreds. Now we're going to divide. What is 40 divided by 10? 40 hundreds divided by 10. So 40 divided by 10 gives us 4. But for what? Well, let's see. So right here, we're going to take our 40 and we're going to divide it into by 10 groups. 1 group, 2 groups, 3 groups, 4 groups, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Another way you could have said, and then so each group is 4. So the answer is 4, and then it's hundreds. Of course, another way we could have done it is we could have looked at groups of 10, one group of 10, another group of 10, another group of 10, and lastly a group of 10 equaling 4 groups. And so the answer is 400s. We could think of it either way. And of course, 400s is equal to 400. So what we want students to see is that the shortcut, and I'm going to erase this, and the shortcut that we want students to see is that we started with 4 in the thousands column, but then when we divided by 10, we ended up with 4 in the hundreds column. I'm just going to do one or two from this table. It says solve each expression by writing the solution in unit form. Parents and teachers, you guys probably don't exactly know what unit form is. So let's take a look at this. 10 times 3 tens, that's going to equal 30 tens. And what I want you to do is I want you to think of this word maybe as replace it with apples. So 10 times 3 apples gives you 30 apples. So that's 30 tens. And then, of course, you could, teachers, at this point, you could have your students visualize or maybe explicitly write out ones, tens, hundreds, so I'm moving real fast, etc. And then they may need to model things or imagine this in our table. So, 30 tens, and every group of 10 equals 100. Oh, okay, so in standard form, this would be 300, because 30 tens is equal to 300s. One last one might be 9 ten thousands divided by 10. Well, 9 ten thousands divided by 10 is 90 thousands. So that's going to be 9 thousands. And then that's going to look like 9,000, like this. All right. So unit form is a phrase that you might not be familiar with, and that's what it looks like. All right, just a little bit more of an example, only now it's getting a little bit more elaborate because now we're mixing our units. So we have ones, tens, And teachers, I make my students draw these charts. I am not nice, and I don't provide it for them. Why is that? Well, it's because I want them to continually practice writing the columns. Ones, tens, hundreds, thousands. And then oftentimes next they go, millions. Okay, no, it's going to be 10 thousands. And we want them to just continually practice that. So I don't give them a chart. I make them write it out. Oh, so let's take a look. Let's take a look at this one right here. So 5 hundreds and 5 tens, and we're going to multiply that by 10. So the idea would be we're going to model this, and it would look like 5 hundreds, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and it would look like 5 tens, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, all right? And then we're going to multiply by 10. So what we want our students to learn is that when we multiply by 10, these 5 dots are going to move into the thousands column, and these 5 dots in the tens are going to move into the hundreds column, because when you multiply by 10, it moves it into the column to your left, because that's the way it is. And then, of course, what ends up over here? Nothing. Nothing ends up there, so we're going to put a big old fat zero. So the idea would be, well, what is our answer in unit form? Well, the answer would be 50 hundreds and 50 tens. Or students might want to write it as 5 thousands and 5 hundreds. I don't know what the answer is in the answer key, but personally as a teacher, I would accept either of those because they're both correct and unit form is nice, but it's not going to have this long-lasting implication if students choose one or the other. I mean, it's not going to impact how they behave or how they're going to perform mathematically in fifth or sixth or seventh grade. And then, of course, the standard form, so you look at your chart down here and you go, oh, look at that, 5,500, and that's our answer. So standard form would look like 5,500. And I like to put commas, but you absolutely do not have to put commas. Similarly, here, if we were to divide, so 4 10,000s divided by 10 gives us 4 thousands. And 8 hundreds divided by 10 gives us 8 tens. And so the standard form would end up looking like this. Now, of course, I kind of went fast on that, and students might need to model it with chips in a place value chart. And but I kind of skipped through that real quick. And last one, what's a video without a word problem to practice? It says, Emily collected $950 selling Girl Scout cookies. I wish I had some of them. Emily's troop collected 10 times as much as she did. So how much money did the troop raise? So the idea would be, well, if we're going to put in Emily's money, $950. So here's our ones. Here's our tens, and here's our hundreds. And then, if we're going to multiply by 10, well, that means this 9 is going to move into the thousands column. This 5 is going to move into the hundreds column. This 0 is going to move into the tens column, so to speak. And then we have nothing left over here. So what do we put right there? We put a big old fat zero because there's nothing there. There's nothing left over. And so the answer is $9,500. 9,000, we should put thousands here. So we end up with 9,500 and nothing else. So 9,500 and nothing else. And that wraps up fourth grade module 1, lesson 2, where we're starting to learn place value and how each column is related to the columns next door.